always tracking, always alerting. This is Storm Team 8.
Good morning, West Michigan. It is 5:16, and we are waking up to a chilly start to the day. Temperatures are below freezing. We've got some icy roads. This is a look at the southern end of the S-curve, the Wealthy Street overpass. And as Tom Hillen was mentioning just a few minutes ago, already looking at some icy spots in some of those bridges and overpasses on and off ramps. So definitely don't overdrive for conditions out there this morning. Even though precipitation that's falling now is going to be very light, we will see it as a mixed bag of light rain, light snow mixing together, and especially across northern lower Michigan and the UP, where we're seeing some shovelable snow, and a winter weather advisory does remain in effect. Yesterday, 44 degrees in Grand Rapids. It was the coldest afternoon since all the way back on April 21st. 44, also the high yesterday in Kalamazoo. So we are definitely settled into an unseasonably cold pocket of air, and that will continue for today, tonight, and into the day tomorrow. The pattern starts to shift on Friday back to partial sunshine and pleasant conditions. But from here to there, patches of ice possible in area roads with cold and frosty conditions this morning. We'll see pockets of isolated rain and snow showers, but considerable lake effect clouds as that cold air continues to stream in across the relatively warmer waters of Lake Michigan. In our Storm Team 8 winter weather special yesterday, Bill Steffen was making the comment that those mid-lake buoy readings are still looking at temperatures in the 50s. So yeah, there's a lot of warm surface water out there for this cold air to interact with, and that's why we are seeing those pockets of precipitation. Temps in the 20s and low 30s, so at or below freezing this morning, just a gentle breeze, and we've got those feels like readings in the 20s and low 30s as well. So definitely warm jackets, gloves, mittens for the little ones out the door at the bus stop. Not a lot of precipitation here. This moisture is all being generated as the cold air crosses the Great Lakes, and so that brings us those isolated pockets of precip the next couple of days. By Friday, the rain chances go down to zero. We've got lots of sunshine around. Impossible to see a stray shower developing later Saturday into early Sunday, but most of the weekend is looking dry, and it looks like a dry and pleasant pattern around here for early next week as well. By the way, remember that time change on Sunday, and then we're back up to around or a touch above 60 degrees early next week. Now, taking a look back at some winter weather seasons past, the first 10 years of the 21st century, our decade average was more than 10 inches above average. Our average now stands at 77.6 inches of snow for a season. You can see three of these 10 years, we had more than 100 inches of snow, including the 2001-2002 season when we had 51 inches of snow in that week between Christmas and New Year's. So pretty interesting here. Then the next 10 years, we had a decade average of only 71.5 inches. Several of these winter seasons were below average, only one above the century mark. And by the way, the last year, what a dismal snow season that was, only 46.1 inches. And by the way, all of this data and a whole lot more available at woodtv.com. Click on the Storm Team 8 section to find all the winter weather information, including the projection for this season. Tom Hillen, how are drivers doing?
Well, this is one of those mornings where you definitely want to use caution on those bridges, overpasses, on and off ramps. That's where we could see some of those more icy conditions. Right now, these are the road temperatures we're looking at in the Grand Rapids area, about 29 degrees. So we're below that freezing mark, hovering right around the freezing area in the Kalamazoo and Portage area. Along the lakeshore, we're doing a little bit better. Temperatures along the roadways there at 35, so above freezing. So that is good news. Still do have a few crashes out there that we are working with. M6 right now, westbound crash after the I-96 interchange, as well as along the eastbound lanes of I-96, that crash between Leonard and the East Beltline. So heads up there. Other than those two crashes, we don't have any other crashes along the area freeways, and so far, no major slowdowns. I'll be back in about 15 minutes with another update for you. Emily?